Shabbat! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Bands, Dr. Satcher, we do the ride around after our band didn't show up to Friday, which we're glad to have you. But at this time, we have a program in front of you, and second page from the back is where we'll be going by. And at this time, we'll have Mayor Draper to come and give us the welcome. Thank you all so very much.
Thank you. Welcome, everyone. And thank you all for being with us here today. This, you know, this is a great opportunity for us to gather and explore opportunities for enhancing our civil rights program. Dr. Satcher, thank you so much for being here with us today. We are truly honored by your presence. Thank you for all that you do. Thank you for your leadership as a humanitarian, as a healthcare advocate, not only for our community, our country, but the world. We're just so proud to have you back home. But let you know, throughout the day, throughout this lunch, let's take this opportunity to fellowship and continue to make our community all that it can be. At this time, I'm very proud to call on Reverend P.Q. English, who will lead us in the invocation and giving thanks. Reverend English.
Let me just pray. Eternal God, our presence here today is not that we have been so good and we've done everything that we were supposed to have done. We're present today for a good reason. And we thank you, our Father, for allowing us to come together as we come across our Father, various walks of life. We thank you for the committee and for the person who have brought this idea to the city of Anniston. We pray that things will go well and that the stones that need turning will be turned, those that need to be left alone will be left in their state. We ask you now, Father, that you will bless our guest speaker, and we thank you for him returning back again to the city of Anniston. Pray for his family and his friend. We ask you now, Father, if you would bless the food that has been prepared. Thank you, our Father, for the food that was served as a nourishment to strengthen our physical body and as a bond to cohes our love and fellowship. For in Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so very much. Thank you, Mayor. At this time, Reverend English, a little introduction and recognition that you see at the head table here. We have Reverend English, pastor of the Greater Thankful Baptist Church, and Mayor Draper, City of Anniston, and this Juanita Gerald here with us, and she's Dr. Satcher, former school teacher. He's laughing at us.
Larry and Carol.
And she's the president of Yasset State Community College. And Larry and Carol Satcher. And Attorney Donald Stewart. And Stewart and Stewart. And yours truly, Dr. David Satcher. Give a hand. We also have with us ministers, and we have the Youth Council, Anniston Youth Council. The council a few months ago, we formed the Youth Council, starting it out, and so they're here today with us, and we're happy to have them with us. And we have in the back the ministers and the principals and head schoolmasters, I think, in lower school, and the school, they have different names than principal. They have the high upper school, the middle school, and anyhow, they're there with us. You all stand with us. Stand.
from different angles and draw things together into a cohesive unit, and I hope that this is the start of a very fruitful process for us all. So, thank you.
I would just say that I'm popping back up, but I think we have next, let's see, Council Reddick, we have City Manager Jay Johnson to come. She was supposed to be on her way in here, and then Attorney Donald Stewart and Ms. Martha Lavender. And then we have Pete Conroy. Pete missing a meal? All right, Pete. Okay, and Ms. Gayle, who Ms. Hearns will say something in her stead. And then we have Mr. Jones. He would come and speak to us. All right, and that was all for me. I won't come back, so you all can just see your name and if Christ is right, come on down.
Welcome into our community and recognize what you have done for Anniston and for our nation. And I also want to take this opportunity to thank all of you for taking time out of your schedule to join us for this luncheon and talk about civil rights and the civil rights history here in Anniston. Thank you, sir.
I'll take a page out of Jay's book. I'm Donald Stewart. I'll stand here, but I wanted to say, Dr. Satcher, we're glad you and your family are here and represented. I was talking to your brother. Some of you young people may want to know that these were courageous people. You don't know what the times were. I'm old enough to know what the times were when these people chose to participate in the integration of a school within our county system. And I was telling my little story, and he shared his with me, embarrassed me over here, but he was telling the truth about a time you don't know about. And I think it's important for us to take something that happened in our community, which is not the best thing that could happen in a community, but to turn it into a good thing for our community, a healing and health facility is a wonderful thing to come out of that time. And I'll say to those of you who serve in public office here on the local level, I'm impressed with this cooperative effort to make something happen in our community. I think it's a significant thing. I think it's a model that if you follow, there are some wonderful things that can happen in Anniston. And I say, as a private citizen now, served in public office, but as a private citizen now, I'm happy to see the cooperation and the effort that y'all are putting into this, and the support you have for the community, I think, will continue, and I wish you good luck. Dr. Satcher, it's our honor to be here. I was telling him, I go to see my grandbaby every once in a while, and I take Northside Drive to get into Atlanta rather than go the regular route. And I go through Morehouse, he tells me I go right by his office when I'm going to see him. So I'll stop by and have a cup of coffee the next time I'm over there. Proud to have you here, your family, and what y'all made by way of contribution to this community. Ms. Gerald, it's good to see you, and I can't believe you called anybody in. Good to be here.
My name is Martha Lavender, and I'm president of Gadsden State Community College. But Dr. Satcher, I want you to know that when I introduce myself to people, I usually introduce myself as a nurse, because I'm a registered nurse and a graduate of Gadsden State and a graduate of Jacksonville State University and University of Alabama at Birmingham, and just kept on going. But sir, I just want you to know that my colleagues in here and I not only want to honor you today and all that you've done, but we so respect the integrity with which you've done your work, and we admire what you're doing, and we want to bless you and be proud of you. Anniston is known for many things, but the shining star that Anniston is known for is Dr. David Satcher. We are very committed to building a better future in this community and in this part of the state. Gadsden State has a key role in that, and I pledge to all of you here and to our students and possibly potential students in the future, We want to build something better for you and for your families. And so that is our commitment to you. And I believe we do that. I tell people every day that we change lives at Gadsden State, but we do it in cooperation with others. Many of them have not had a strong opportunity. They are what we call in government disadvantaged for a number of reasons. But I too would have been considered a disadvantaged student because of my background, and it had nothing to do with my ability or my attitude. And so as I look at these young people here, I tell you, we have a citizen that we can role model after, and I encourage you to do that. And if there's any way that we can assist you with that at Gadsden State, we stand ready and able to do that. Thank you, sir, for being here.
From Commerce and Visitor Center. It says Gail McCauley, but if you know Gail, you will know that I'm obviously not Gail McCauley today. But on behalf of the Calhoun County Chamber of Commerce, Dr. Satcher, we want to thank you. We want to welcome you and thank you for making a difference in our community. We appreciate the vision, because we've got to begin with a vision and follow it through, for that is the way great tomorrows come true. And on behalf of the Chamber of Commerce, we appreciate everybody coming together, working together, sharing that vision. Thank you for the enhancements and the growth of this community and bringing health into Calhoun County. And this is a great quality of life program for our area, for the Chamber, for this community, and for our whole area. And thank you so much.
Dr. Satcher, it's a privilege to be here and to see you, and thank you for coming to Anniston and for coming back into Alabama. And thank you, Council Little, for inviting me here. And you know, this year is our 200th birthday. We're celebrating our bicentennial here in Alabama. I can't think of a better year than for an initiative like this to begin, because this is a year where we're remembering our past and our culture and all of it, and not just remembering, but planning a road into the future. So I can't think of a better year than our bicentennial to be announcing this. Thank you.
Everyone should have a sheet like this in front of me. If you look at A, that is the proposed site. If you know where the DHR building is, it's old chart line site. If you know where the DHR building is located now, it's north of the DHR building. It's where Dr. Satcher was looking at the initial site. The secondary site is position B. That's right behind General Jackson Barbershop there. There's a building called the Mine Shaft that Mr. Romine had, that red top. I'll have to come out and try to clear that area out in there. It's a secondary site, but we hopefully can, we will be getting with Dr. Satcher to talk about some things, what it's like in the institute, things of that nature, be getting with him about that. And if you look at C, Dr. Satcher, that is the trail, that then the exercise trail, the health, what's the name of it, the fitness trail, the wellness trail that they had earlier for you, incorporated that into it also. And if you look at D, that is an old Lauderdale site. Right, 17th Street runs right into it and stopped. We want to try to connect that on through. But right now, that's where we're proposing. Hopefully, we're just working it out. We've council been talking about it. The old Senior Citizen Center, one-stop social shop along with that. We have a place out on the fort right now. We'd like to bring it into the city and sort of develop that area. And we don't know for sure yet. That's site. If you look on A, to the right side of A, that is the trail also, and that's something I forgot to put in here. But to the right side of the trail, going north toward the wellness trail, along that trail will be different markers about people that was active in the civil rights movement. And as people leaving the Institute and the Civil Rights Museum and walking along the trail north toward 15th Street, they'll be able to look at markers and different things that transpired in Anniston in the area during the Civil Rights Movement. And hopefully it will spring off into 15th Street and for some new development to take place in West and 15th Street also down there. And so this project will be bigger than just, I think it just revitalized West Anniston and help Anniston in its, live Anderson in a lot of ways. And I think it would be national attention drawn for bringing people in to the museum. We already have three great locations, the Anniston Museum of Natural History, and the Burma Museum, and the Botanical Garden, those three things. So with these two things putting together in Anniston, I think you have a plethora of people coming into Anniston and viewing Anniston and looking at the history of Anniston and talking about wellness and things of that nature also, and views and things. So like Attorney Stewart said, I think it's great. It feels good to, and I love working together with people. And it's something that the council didn't hesitate on when we talked about doing this, Dr. Satcher, and the mayor, they said yes, and then we were talking over the last 2 days, and really putting things together to try to make something happen nice. And you deserve it, Anniston deserve it, and the community deserve it, you deserve it. I think we can do great things together. So we're looking forward to it. So enjoy yourself, and at this time, I think we have a getting to lunchtime right now, we can start eating. So just talk and fellowship with another. Again, we're so happy to see all of you here, and looking for great things to happen. Thank you so very much. Let me have your attention, please. You can continue to eat. Just before Larry Satcher, Dr. Satcher's brother comes to introduce him. His sister, she's here. That is, you want to say hello to us?
Raise your hand.
She has some here.
Oh, okay. Say hello back there.
This is his sister.
Amen.
Amen. Give her a hand. Thank you for being here. And I want to say, too, thank you to General Jackson. When we were talking about pulling together, he had to contact some people, hey, because I didn't know. He said, well, you know, need to talk with this one and that one, and we pulled it together. Thank you, General Jackson. Matter of fact, and just since you're still eating, I want to go around the room, just stand and say your name, please, so Dr. Satcher can see who you are. Amen. We start right here with Mr. Gregory. Say who you are.
Good afternoon. I'm Charles D. Gregory, Sr. I'm the principal of Anniston High School and the very grateful pastor of the Victory Headquarters Christian Center. And we're just elated to be here today, accompanying two of our great students. Honored to finally meet you, Dr. Satcher, and so very, very proud of the work that you've done and continue to do.
Good afternoon. My name is General Jackson. I'm a business owner of West 15th Street and the active ED of the CDC. And Dr. Satcher, I would like to say it's been a long time coming, but a change is about to come. Thank you.
All right. Okay, we'll start with you, Council Taylor.
Dr. Satcher, thank you for coming back to Anniston. I'm Russ Cadell, the middle and upper school director of the Donahoe School.
extremely an honor to be here with you, and I appreciate the city for inviting us and our students. Thank you so much.
I'm Roland Brown. I'm pastor of Golden Springs Baptist Church, and thank you for being here and reminding us that there is hope.
Jeremiah Russell, principal at Sacred Heart Catholic School. I want to again thank the city for inviting our students so they can experience the importance of civics. Dr. Satcher, I want to thank you for being here as well.
I'm Chip Jones, head of school at Faith Christian School, and thank you so much for including us and our students and for this wonderful event. Thank you.
Mr. Steele.
My name is Joe Steele Jr. I'm retired principal of Lower Belvoir School.
Hi, I'm Sheila Smith. I am with Networks Media Consultants, Inc. I'm a consultant with the city of Anniston and a consultant in Birmingham as well. And I'm a former Jefferson County Commissioner at Birmingham.
And I told you with this when we sprung this idea, you want to sprung the idea of getting this thing to take a jump start here on this project.
Well, Dr. Satcher, I've actually followed you for quite a while. I'm quite in awe of your presence, and I did used to live in Anniston. So I'm very familiar with the fact that you were connected. And just think for letting Ben follow up when I gave him the idea that we should probably do something in your honor in your own city because of your very elaborate healthcare background. And certainly, it's very unusual to have somebody from here at that high level in a presidential cabinet. That is very, very special. And we've been very fortunate enough in this state to have two as well. So this is my second time being a U.S. Surgeon General, actually my third time. So I'm very honored to have you here, and hopefully we can do what is per the vision of this city and this mayor and this council and all the people here. We are very, very excited that you have decided to grace us with your presence in Anniston.
My name is Clay Dorsey, Dorsey Architects. I'm located in Birmingham. I'd like to thank you very much for inviting me.
All right, I think that is it. And at this time now, if you missed anyone, raise your hand. All right, thank you. All right, at this time, we'll call on Mr. Larry Satcher to come and introduce our honored guest of the day, Dr. David Satcher.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Yeah, my name is Larry Satcher. I'm David's youngest brother. But Dr. Satcher was a child of the late Anna and Wilma Satcher. I'll say a few things about them. It kind of tell you where he came from. Wilma Satcher was a deacon in the church, Mount Liberty Baptist Church, and a Sunday school teacher. In fact, he was known citywide as being one of the best Sunday school teachers people would invite. Churches would invite him from all the cities to come to teach Sunday school. My mother was very active in the church too. So that kind of gives you some background, but you know how much time we spend in church. he had seven siblings, there were six boys and two girls. And I'm telling you all this thing you may not know. If you want to know what the details about, you know, students, it's in the program, you can read all those details. But he had seven siblings, six boys and two girls. He had nine children. Let me explain that. he had four children. He was married to Callie Hernan, who passed early on, and by her he had four children. But he later married Noah Richardson, who he's married to now. And she had, and those were his stepchildren. He had five stepchildren, and he took them on as his own children. Even though when they were married, they were all grown, but he still considered him to be their, you know, their father. He was raised on a farm. We all were. So he knows how to milk cows, plow fields, how to feed chickens. All that kind of stuff he knew how to do because that's the way he was raised. Graduated from Calhoun County Training School at Val Fair, Victoria. Cuyahoga County Training School. One of the things, he also, my father worked at the Air Force Foundry, and so of course, me and my brothers, also when they got to high school, you know, they had to work at the Air Force Foundry too. David was one of the best opportunities to work at the Air Force Foundry. Fortunately, my younger brother, I had a twin brother, we didn't have to do that. We came on later on, so we got out. But one interesting story he told me, he also worked for Jeff Hamburg. How many of y'all remember Jeff Hamburg?
Oh, yeah.
Wow. One of the very bad, what, 50s and 60s, very popular hamburgers fans. Some of the best. They used to make what they call scrummer burgers. Do you remember the Jet Hamburger? I know some of y'all remember Jet Hamburger. They just closed down maybe a couple years ago. And they were patterned after the Jet Hamburger. Well, anyway, Dave always told me that all the employees who worked with Jeff Hamburg because he paid so little salary, they would steal from him. You know, they would have curbside service, and you know, they would get the money from the customers and pocket some of the money. Everything Jeff knew, he knew what was going on. You know, he was very small, he knew they were taking money from him. But one day he brought David to the side and he said, David, I really appreciate you. You are the only employee that I ever had that never stole. So that really had a big impression on me. It showed something about his integrity and his background. And I think that he carried that over and also into his adult life. Okay, so I introduce to you Dr. David Satcher. Thank you very much.
Very much. I have to tell you, I was sitting there trembling in my seat because when somebody knows too much about you, Barry does about me. just keep wondering what part of it. I'm happy that he told the good part. But seriously, I'm delighted to be here. Thanks very much, Councilman, and all of you who contributed to bringing us together. I've had a lot of opportunities in my life, as you can imagine, going back to my days here in Atlanta and up until today. I've been all over the world, I've worked all over the world, I've worked with the World Health Organization, and just recently completed a stint with the Commission on Social Determinants of Health. So I've had a lot of opportunities to serve, and I've tried to serve in such a way that it makes a positive difference. It means a lot to me that you would even consider this kind of memorial, I guess I'll call it, in my honor. But you should know that as far as I'm concerned, I want to be in there working with you. So whatever we do, I hope together we can do something that's going to continue to improve the health of the community, and especially to provide more opportunities for our young people. I had a chance to meet all of the students earlier, and I'm really happy that they're here. That means a lot to me. I've spent much of my life, as most of you know, working with students, in medicine especially, in nursing. Education is important to me. One of the most important persons in my life in history is sitting right here. Ms. Gerald was just an outstanding teacher because she cared about students. I often say we need more leaders, more teachers who first care enough. Then we need them to know enough. Then we need them to have the courage to do enough. And finally, we need them to persevere until the job is done. And the fact that she's here today means that she's still persevering. In one sense, you might say that I survived Ms. Joe, because she was determined that I was not going to take for granted, you know, the coursework. That if it were easy for me, she would find a way to give me something more difficult. So she would send me to the library. She wanted me to write a paper on the Constitution or the Declaration of Independence. Interesting, because one of those papers won an award, didn't it?
Yeah.
But I was only doing it because she made me go to the library. But seriously, I point to her because she symbolizes, I think, what this is all about. We've got to make the world a better place for the people who are coming after us. And each of us has that responsibility. And I think role models when it comes to that. And certainly, Ms. Gerald, the person that I think of often. Many of you know Pappy Don. I'll tell you a story about Pappy Don. One day we went to class, and as you know, Pappy Don coached everything, football, basketball, whatever. And he also taught chemistry. And I remember going to chemistry class one day, and Pappy Don waved his hand like that for me to come up front. And I came up there, and he whispered,
"Satcher, I have laryngitis."
I didn't know what laryngitis was at the time. And then he said, "That means I want you to teach the class."
Wow.
Figuring out, why would he be? He doesn't even know if I read the chapter. But that's what he did. And he found that, you know, that I did know something about balancing equations in chemistry. And that became a story of his. I remember when I applied to Morehouse, and Morehouse was not easy on us. They said they had never had an alumnus from Calhoun County Training School. And therefore, they questioned why they should take a chance on me. And Pappy Don took me over to meet B.O. Belia. Some of you know B.O. I think some of you have been that long. Insurance. I guess so. But anyway, he and Pappy were friends. And so Belia, who was a Morehouse graduate, called the office at Morehouse and said that he had this student here. And they explained that they didn't have any graduates. So Pappy Don told me that I was such a great student that I occasionally walked on water. So Delia shared all of that with the people at Morehouse, and they said, "Okay, we'll take a chance on him, but we don't usually do that." So I went to Morehouse, of course, and after we took an exam for the whole week, it was not as tough as the exam Ms. Gell gave. So I took the exam, and the next week they posted, and I was somewhere in the top 10. So they put us, she said I was number 3, okay. Anyway, they put us in a special class so that all during the year we would be challenged. And I thought about being challenged in high school, not being allowed to take anything for granted in terms of my responsibility to learn and to make best of the opportunity that I had. So it was great. I've been around a long time, even though Larry is quite a few years younger than I am. Been around a long time, and I've had a lot of great experiences. What has not been publicized very much is that I became quite involved in the student movement at Morehouse because there came a time when Morehouse students and Spelman students and others decided that we had a responsibility to really help desegregate Atlanta. Stores downtown like Richards and others were making a lot of money off of African Americans and not hiring African Americans. So we decided that it was our responsibility. So I had an experience. In fact, last week, Lonnie King, some of you might know that name. Lonnie was 3 years ahead of me at Morehouse, and he never finished. He dropped out later, but he's the one that motivated us to start a movement in Atlanta, to make Atlanta better. And by the time I was a senior, I was the responsible for that movement. And one day, going after having been arrested for trying to eat at a restaurant that didn't serve us. Or the chief of police had called Dr. Mays and said, I have one of your students here. And Dr. Mays said, well, you just make sure you take care of him. But to make a long story short, we decided to go on a hunger strike. I mean, you know the story of Gandhi and others, but a young lady from Spelman actually had the idea about going on a hunger strike. Everybody gave me the credit for it because I was the head of the group at the time. So I went a whole week without eating, and I will never forget that week in terms of what it did for me, in terms of how I think and how I feel. And then while we were in jail, Coca-Cola called a meeting of the business leaders, and they decided that it was time to change, that they didn't want people all over the world reading about students in jail on a hunger strike. So I give Coca-Cola a lot of credit for that. And I sometimes spend time with them all day sometimes talking about how to reduce sugar in drinks and stuff. But I mean, they've come a long ways, and we still have a long ways to go. I think what can be, there are three or four things that I hope will happen in Anniston. One, of course, I hope that we will take seriously the opportunity that we have to improve the health of people in this city. Because we do have a tremendous opportunity. You know, I can talk about what I've done, what I've had the opportunity to do as Surgeon General. As Director of the CDC, people don't talk much about my tenure as Director of the CDC, but in many ways, in my mind, it's one of the most important jobs I've ever had. It was a global job. I worked with people all over the world. I like to tell a story of the time when we had decided we were going to eradicate polio. And I had teams in different countries. And then when it came time to do the actual immunization, they asked me to come and participate. And we immunized 100 million children in 1 week. 100 million children. And I went back to India a few years after that, and I ran into this guy who was paralyzed. He had polio. So I asked him about his polio, and he said, well, I have polio, but I have 5 children, and none of them have polio because of the immunization that was done earlier. In other words, a lot of problems that we have, we talk about the heart disease and cancer, we ought to find a way to make sure that our children do not suffer those same ills. One of my favorite Surgeon General's story, and I'm known for telling stories about the Surgeon's General, but it was Luther Terry. How many of you know that name? Luther Terry released a report on smoking and health in 1964. And a few years ago, we evaluated the impact that report had had, and we were amazed at the number of lives that have been saved. But the story is that when Luther Terry was going to the press conference to release his report, this was 1964, it was a Saturday morning. Not a good time to have a press conference. I'm sure not even an answer. But Luther Terry was assigned that because there were people in power who didn't want him to release their report because they were making so much money off of tobacco. But Luther Terry was on the way to the press conference. He was sitting in the back seat with his assistant. He was smoking more than usual. So his assistant said, well, Dr. Terry, do you know the first question they're going to ask you when you release this report? And he said, no, what's that? I said, well, they're going to ask you if you smoke. And he said, no, they wouldn't ask me that. Why would that's a personal question? So he went on to the press conference. He released the report. He did a great job. First question, Dr. Terry, do you smoke? And he said, no, I don't. And the reporter had done his job, right? So he said, well, Dr. Terry, when did you quit? And he said, I quit 30 minutes ago. He never smoked again. lapel pin saying thank you for not smoking. It's never too late to quit doing those things that we know are not good for us. Whether it's the way we eat, whether it's smoking, whether it's the fact that we're not physically active on a regular basis. And I was very happy when they developed this trail in my honor a few years ago. What I am concerned about is the extent to which people are using it. And so I'm anxious now to come up with a strategy, even if it's providing some funds to churches or what have you, where they would make an effort to get members of their congregation to be more physically active. Of all of the interventions I can think of, and I have this Surgeon General's prescription, which some of you've seen, but of all of the interventions, physical activity is probably at the top. I mean, that's regardless of how old you are, you know, how much you weigh. Physical activity can make probably the greatest difference in health outcome. This is the Surgeon General's prescription. And the first thing on here, number one, moderate physical activity at least 5 days a week, at least 30 minutes a day. It's never too late to quit. And whatever that is you're doing that you know you shouldn't be doing. But it's also never too late to begin a behavior that benefits your health and the health of others. I think our young people especially are struggling. There's a lot of violence that they have to live with. There's people shooting mass, large numbers of people. There's a lot they're struggling with. And as you know, some of the kids from the shooting in Florida last year have committed suicide, at least a week too. So it's a difficult environment to live in, the violence that's going on. It hurts not only the people who are directly affected or the people who perpetrate it. It hates our whole environment. So we need to do everything we can to reduce violence. When I was director of CDC, a politician from Mississippi, Jay Dickey, whom some of you might know, introduced legislation to take money away from the CDC because of the research we were doing dealing with gun violence. So they took all of the money away. And so it's really dramatically decreased gun violence research. However, Jay Dickey years later decided that he was wrong. He wrote an op-ed piece in the Washington Post saying he was wrong. But Jay Dickey was not able to get this Congress, the one that came out to him, to retract what he had done. And last year, Jay Dickey died after writing op-ed pieces and all kinds of things saying how wrong he was to take money away from research dealing with gun violence. I got to know Jay Dickey and during those years after he introduced that legislation and before he died. He had sort of made it right. He felt much better about what he had done, but he would have loved to have seen the money restored. But it hasn't stopped. It hasn't actually stopped us from doing research in gun violence. But the sad thing is that there's still so much gun violence, so much in the streets, so much in homes. And many people don't realize it, but one of the major ways in which guns are used is in committing suicide. Mental health problems leading to suicide, one of the major ways in which guns are involved in violence and death. Well, I hope I could talk about a lot of things we can do. I could talk about cancer. I could talk about Alzheimer's, which my wife is suffering from now. And all over the country, as people get older, there are people who are beginning to suffer from various forms of dementia. Hopefully, we will continue the research, and hopefully we will find ways to prevent brain disease. And as you know, many of the athletes, especially the NFL players, who now retired are suffering from dementia. I've worked very closely with NFL now for several years, trying to really emphasize the importance of preventing head injuries. And thankfully, the NFL has finally created a system where if you intentionally engage in head-to-head contact, you're out of that game and maybe the next one. So we're beginning to see a decline in those kind of head injuries. These are all things that we can do. I didn't talk about what the doctors can do yet. And I know that's what you expect me to talk about, and I talk about it a lot. But all of these are things that we can do as a community. We can work together to make our communities safer. We can work together to prevent a lot of the diseases and illnesses that confront us. We can do that. It's never too late to quit. Luther Terry came to the press conference just having quit, but then he spent the rest of his life helping other people to quit. 10 years ago, I went to China with Senator Fritz, Bill Fritz, who is a physician also. And the Chinese wanted help in getting their people to quit smoking. We have, since the Terry report, we have decreased smoking in this country from almost 50% of the population to less than 15%. And we calculated when Regina Benjamin was in office that we have saved over 20 million lives throughout the world because of that report. So there's a lot of lives that we can save, there are a lot of ways we can make our communities healthy. So I am excited about the opportunity to work with you and do whatever I can do to improve the health of this community. And when I say the health, I know that also means wealth. I know somebody asked me this morning, they did a pretty long interview, and they wanted to know from me if, in fact, if we look at the health of a community like this and others, how do we go about predicting the things that are most important to target? And that's not easy, but the sooner we start, the better. And so the young people have an opportunity to improve their own lifestyles. They have an opportunity to improve the lifestyles of those around them. Dr. Mays, who was president of Morehouse for 27 years, used to speak to the students every Tuesday morning. And we were required to go to chapel. I mean, if you didn't go to chapel at Morehouse, and we had chapel 6 days a week. If you didn't go and you got ready to graduate and they saw on your record that you had missed more than a certain number of chapels, they would pull you out of line so you couldn't graduate. Well, that changed later on, but that was a part of the history. So let me leave you with one of my favorite Benjamin Mays quotes. Dr. Mays used to say that it must be borne in mind that the great tragedy of life is not in failing to reach all your goals. It's in having no goals for which you're reaching. It's not a calamity if somehow you die with dreams unfulfilled, but it is a calamity not to dream. It's not a disgrace if you fail to reach the stars. It's a disgrace to have no stars for which you're reaching. In the final analysis, he said, and I say today, not failure, but low aim is sin. Thank you.
Small token of our collective appreciation. The Youth Council is here to present you with a print of the Noble Street Festival, which will be this weekend, so y'all go back downtown, and two books on the history of Anniston. And we hope that the chapter we're writing now will be a positive one that will be impactful for our kids and the one that they write will be as well. And I think one of their number will, just like to say, just a couple words. And finally, this is probably long overdue, but on behalf of the city of Anniston, we're really proud to present you with a key to the city of Anniston. And you know, we really look forward to, you know, a long partnership with you. We appreciate all that you have done. We sincerely do. I can't think of a better ambassador for the city of Anniston, and we're just so proud to have you back home. We're just so thankful. But we know you're gonna keep coming back. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank y'all. I think that this has been a great opportunity for fellowship. We've learned a lot. I think going forward, there are a lot of great projects that we could work on, and the least of which will be, not the least of which will be to honor Dr. Satcher for all that he's done. But with respect to enhancing the Civil Rights Trail, with the improvement of health for our area, I really think that some great things will be born out of this. And finally, before we adjourn, I would like to call on a great friend and mentor to lead us in prayer as we leave here. Dr. Roland Brown, pastor of the Gold Springs Baptist Church. Thank you, Dr. Brown.
That's pretty good.
Heavenly
Father, thank you for men like Dr. Satcher. Who see what needs to be done and set about doing it. Who show us that our past does not limit our future. That remind us every day that the people we live with, the people we rub shoulders with, are the people that matter. And if we really want to change the world, allow us to change ourselves and the one next to us. Thank you for these who are here, who have this dream, who have our hopes for Anniston. And I pray, God, that you will bless them and keep them. You'll make your face shine upon them, and you will give them peace. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Thank you all.
If you would, I think the media, you all want to talk with Dr. Satcher. Dr. Satcher is, the next room over there, and we get a picture with the youth. Is it okay with you, Dr. Satcher?
So let's start giving. There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true, we'll make a better day just you and me. When you're down, it's true, we'll make a better day, just you and me.